Welcome to tonight's story with Mummy Imagination. It's time to relax. Get into your comfiest position in bed. Make sure your pillows are in the right place and that you're under the covers, all warm and snug. You want to make sure that you're going to be warm, but not too warm. And this meditation is best when you're laying down, either in your bed or on the floor, because you're probably going to fall asleep. So when you're ready, close your eyes. We're going to start tonight's meditation by taking a big breath in and out again. I want you to take another deep breath in and hold it. Now think of all today's problems, and as you let go of your breath, let them go. In your mind, you can see all of your problems disappearing. They're gone for tonight. There's nothing left to worry you. This is your safe place. Another deep breath in and out again. If you've got thoughts running through your mind, that's okay. It's quite normal. Just make sure you always come back to the sound of my voice and listen to my instruction. It's time to relax your whole body. Feel your body sinking into the mattress. Your whole body is getting heavy. Make sure to keep your eyes closed. You've had a big day today, and you're going to have another big day tomorrow. So now it's time to get a good night's sleep. But before you go to the land of Nod, let's read a bedtime story. Once upon a time, a princess was playing with her favourite golden ball nearby. There was a very deep pond. Suddenly, the ball bounced and fell into the pond. The princess cried because she had lost her favourite ball. "Don't cry, princess. I can help you," came a voice from the bushes. The princess was surprised to see an ugly frog looking at her. "All right, if you can bring me my ball, I'll give you many jewels," said the princess.
"I don't want expensive things,"
said the ugly frog. I only want to eat and drink with you and sleep in your bed. That's all I ask. Because the princess wanted her golden ball back very much, she agreed with the frog. In a flash, the frog jumped into the pond and brought out the golden ball. However, the princess did not want to keep her promise. Instead, she quickly ran away back to the castle. That night, while the princess and the other members of the royal family were having dinner, suddenly the frog appeared before them. "I've come to have dinner with the princess. She promised me this morning," said the frog, jumping onto the dining table. The king was very angry, but he asked his daughter first.
"Is what the frog say true?"
The princess told her father what had happened.
"Then you must keep your promise," said the king.
The frog had dinner with the princess. He ate so greedily that everyone else at the dining table lost their appetite. Then it was time for bed. The princess did not want the dirty, ugly frog to sleep in her bed. She chased the frog out.
"If you don't keep your promise, you'll turn into a frog," said the frog.
Because she was afraid, the princess let the frog sleep in her bed. While she was sleeping, the princess accidentally touched the frog's cold, slimy body. She felt disgusted and immediately pushed the frog off the bed.
"Ouch!" cried the frog in pain.
The princess felt sorry. "I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you," she said. Suddenly, the frog changed into a tall and handsome prince. The princess was very surprised. The frog was a prince from a neighboring kingdom who had been cursed. He could only become a prince again if he met a beautiful princess who would eat and drink with him and allow him to sleep in her bed while he was a frog. After listening to the prince's story, the king agreed to let the princess marry the prince. And they lived happily ever after. And that's the end of the story. I think sometimes we learn things from stories that we read. What did this story teach you? Sometimes, when things look a certain way, we think a certain way, and we judge that person or that thing by the way they look. But you never know. An ugly frog just may be a prince on the inside. Now that's something to think about. Now that the story's over, it's time to let your body relax, let your head relax, Let your arms relax. Feel your body relaxing and your arms getting heavy. Think about your knees and your legs. You can feel them all letting go. All the muscles are getting heavy. Even your feet may be falling to the side now, as you no longer have any control. You can feel each toe. They feel heavy and loose. If you're still awake, feel free to listen to the rest of the music while you drift off to sleep. And hopefully, we'll see you back again tomorrow for another story. Good night.
you.